All right, welcome back to round two. We're going to keep this hand. Couple reasons, and they don't involve the five drops. Well, they involve one of the five drops. Number one, we're on the draw, so that helps us out a little bit. We need more lands. Number two, we have Archangel Thune, best card in the deck by far, so it's worth mentioning. Number three, we have the combo of Train Condor plus Master of Diversion, which is very, very strong. So, and we only needed one more land to get there. It means you're attacking for four unblockable every turn, and getting your ground guy through by tapping it while protecting the Master Diversion so you can, you know, get away with bigger, better things. Card's not bad. I need another white, obviously. Of course, you always lead with the Trained Condor. So that way, if she plays like a Hill Giant, I can still attack next turn. I guess in this case, I could have attacked anyway, but should have lead with 2/2/2s. How about that? Is there a spell that makes 2/2/2s? I don't think so. There's Talran's Invocation in the last M4, M13 or whatever. But I don't think there's anything like that in M14. Scroll Thief. So I don't really want to give him a card. But at the same time, I'm going to make him use removal or something on my guy. Because I have this in my hand, so getting him to use whatever way he has to get this through on this, if it's his only way to deal with this, then I have come out significantly farther ahead. Like that, I'm willing to trade. Because now, if I cast the Archangel, I'm set. If I don't cast the Archangel, I'll have Celestial Flare up. Basically what it comes down to. Yep. So now he's going to have to have another way. Maybe as a Disperse or something, but or Liturgy of Blood, I guess, would make some amount of sense. Oh, Essence Scatter? Jesus. That was a blowout. That was a legit blowout. Alright, so into the Messenger Draco. Let's hope it doesn't have a rule spell. I don't want to trade this for this, but I will block here, obviously. What's on the back of this? Is that like a potion? Sensory deprivation, sure. Obviously not close here. Sentinel Silver. So I probably need to try to limit what I. No, he's going to take two. Alright, that's cool. So do that. Let's give him a card. And then I don't think I'm blocking. Yeah, I am. What I'm talking about. Alright, so we still have a shot this game. Losing Archangel. If that was the best play, yeah, that's good for us. So, we have nothing in the yard to get back with, dude. We have this. Which is better than nothing. Holds off these scroll thieves and stuff. We need to draw a pacifism, basically. We'll be set. Or claustrophobia would be fine. Well, I can tell you what we're going to draw. This really sucks. I could use just a bounce off there. Maybe it would have been better, I don't know, but it seems like if he has all these tempo plays, if I don't start clearing his board, I'm going to be dead very quickly. Attacking and giving something flying is not something I can even really consider right now. Oh, I didn't attack? Jesus, come on. It's so hard to pay attention while you're talking about stuff. You have no idea. Stuff that is of the exact same material, but a different nature. It's very difficult. It's like trying to remember a number when somebody's yelling various numbers at your face. It's almost exactly like that. If us. Alright, well, good news is we don't have a lot of instant sources. The bad news is we haven't drawn any of them, so he's probably going to hit one. I guess we drew two of them. This game's over for sure. Yep, didn't hit one. Well, that would have been our saving grace. He didn't even hit an enchantment to get back. That's just rude. Alright, let's attack with this dude, because we can. Should have gotten him for 2, he should be at 12. We'll keep that number in our heads. Coming in for 4. I'm just going to take it. Next turn, if I bounce this. Or if I bounce this in a turn specifically. It'll give us a chance to draw a cancel. Also gives us more information on what he's doing with the rest of his turn. Liturgy of Blood. Can't really allow that, can I? Well, the good news is if he hits an enchantment, if he hits pacifism, this actually might work out in our favor. Oh, he had a counterspell. Alright. Well, he can still hit pacifism and could draw claustrophobia. Or either way, either order. Nope, he had illusory armor. And we can't draw a planar cleansing. So we're definitely dead. That sucked. He both saw our out to top deck, and now he gets to play around it for future games, and we weren't able to draw it. That sucked. What can I possibly do against this guy? He's got a million gigantic flyers, and we have one way to really break that. I mean, I could go for this, but half the time I can't even get these guys to trigger once, much less twice. So, duress? I mean, this is a way to break it, but this requires going a completely different color. Can I win this matchup, though? That's what I'm trying to figure out. And I don't know. Like, I have so many cards that just don't do things. I board out those, brought in Molten Rebirths and Mountains and try to get lucky. This is a it's a bold tactic. Just so we're clear. So I have 5 and 5. This is so bad. Maybe I'm supposed to have 4 and 5. Just get really lucky. No, that doesn't feel right. Alright, I'm predicating this strategy. Oh, I get more lands. I forgot I got to add more lands. So 6 and 5. 6 and 5. Alright, so it's not as bad. Alright, this strategy is predicated on getting lucky, but I think I need to do that in this matchup, just the viewing the cards that he had. I just can't beat so many of them unless I draw Planar Cleansing, which is one part of getting lucky, but I've introduced the second part of getting lucky, which is 2 Molten Rebirths and an Archaeomancer.